All right, so this is just a kind of a quick off-the-cuff informal video on how to shuffle all the frames of a video, similar to what I did for the video for All Star by Smash Mouth. And so the way I did that was kind of a lot of trial and error with Excel files, and the final result I ended up generating using Python. And so I found the easiest way was to just go with a purely Python approach. And so obviously this video is not intended for people who understand Python at all. So I'm not going to go into detail on this script, but basically it's just going to ask for the full path to the video, the frame rate of the video, and the number of frames in the video. So I've prepared an example of a live version of the song Never Gonna Give You Up, and I just chose it simply because it's 30 frames per second. So it's an integer number, and I just wanted to make sure. I think that'll work better. And so it's also a very small video. It's only 352 by 240, and so that'll make sure that I can, you know, demonstrate the preview pretty quickly without having to render out the whole thing. So I can just run the Python script, and you can see I've run it earlier. So if I just clear the screen. Okay, so shuffle frames, enter the full path to the video. So I copy this one. The video's frame rate is 30. Let me just show how to quickly get the frame rate of the video. So I'll just drag this clip into Sony Vegas, set the project video settings to match this media. And if I go to the properties here, I gotta fix that color thing. You can see the frame rate is 30. And I also will need to know the number of frames in the video. So if you go to the timeline here, you want to select absolute frames. So I just click on the very end of the video, 7,296 frames. I already put that here for my information. So 30 FPS, 7,296 frames, and it generates the file. It's right here. So I'm going to just delete this from here. Now import that EDL file. And it's going to want to make a new project. So we can see here, let me just make sure the settings are good. Okay, great. So it's already generated something. We can just see it appears to be a long gray bar, but really it's just all these boundaries of all the clips. And we have, you know, it fades in and fades out for the audio for all these clips. And I could just, you know, skip to them and see those certainly look pretty random to me. So I might as well play the, you know, just go to a random part in the original just to show kind of what it was like. It's just a music video. And now I'm gonna play the shuffled result. And let's see here. Yeah, it's not pretty to watch or listen to, but if you want to do that, that's how to do it. So I guess I'll put the Python script in the description of this video, and I guess have at it.